Good morning. So it's actually not morning. I tried to record this earlier and I couldn't find any batteries that were charged. So I had to charge batteries while I basically argued on Twitter about, you know, Adidas and Jordan and Nike and Kanye and all these things. I was supposed to be up in the mountains already. I was gonna go up Saturday, but I woke up Saturday and I was insanely sick. I have no clue why or what. I just got super sick and then ended up laying on my bathroom floor for like 2 hours. Felt kind of like weak all day and then better by dinner time. So a lot of changes in the house, as you may be able to tell. The kitchen is super clean. Portions of the couch have returned. The TV is now gone. And then we have an entirely new bedroom set up here. Whoosh. All set up this way now. There's no sheet on this bottom part anymore. And this floor is very clean because it had to be shampooed. Just like the rest of these floors here that had to be cleaned thoroughly, because Omar has been sick since he ate an entire bag of peanuts. So the whole house got basically clean. So, and I didn't do it. I'm not gonna take credit for it. All my laundry. So, oh, I should probably pick this up. All that got done. So, shout out to Alex. She hooked it up, so. Yeah, guess I should probably buy her a pair of shoes or something today. The house is super clean except for, so I gotta get this all straightened up and got drawings I've been working on for future drops. A lot of stuff happening, I'll get to that in a sec. Today also we're gonna do the reason that this all happened. I'm going to move all of the Twitch stuff, out of there and into here, over there, and Twitch out here. It's just easier for me to use this whole common space, it's a creative place, and then I can get my shoe room back and get all of these really awesome shoes that I love back in their respective places and go through all the stuff that I have and figure out what I need to get rid of. It's almost time for another shoe sale because I just got worried about all the BYW stuff that's coming and all the shoes that are dropping after June, and I will literally not have room if I cop everything. That's how the day is starting. That's what I'm gonna get going on. I'm gonna start moving this stuff as I spin around my living room, and you'll understand why Ernie's not here in just a moment. Last week was pretty stressful for me. I don't know how much of it is noted or really can be told, but building a brand is very stressful. I don't even know how this all started. So basically it all started because I saw our automated response. If you send an email to my customer service team, if you buy a shirt from us and you send an email, it sends out an automated response. I had asked for it to be changed months ago because I didn't like it originally. I saw it again for the first time forever, and I guess just with being busy, I didn't notice or whatever that hadn't been changed, but it was still the same kind of like cold, very like rule abiding auto response, and I didn't like it because I'm just like any of you guys. Like when I buy something, or I'm a customer, I buy a lot of shit. So it's like I expect certain things, you know, fast shipping, communication, tracking, all those things. I also expect when I have an issue, I get anxiety when I have an issue, and then I want to get it taken care of. And when I reach out, I just want to know that, you know, that I'm being heard, or that my issue, at least that, you know, someone gives a shit, right? So I noticed all these things that were happening in our customer service, and I put a lot of faith in the people that I hire, and I put a lot of faith into them just doing what the standards that we've set and what we all expect just as customers, just like how I do it. And I put a lot of faith in people sometimes, and maybe I should. Essentially last week I just figured out there was a lot of issues, like going through emails and finding just like shirts that never got shipped. And you know, there's a lot of people that are trying to scam me too. There's a lot of people on my email never ordered, or you know, all kinds of things that are like obvious scams. Give people the benefit of the doubt as well, and we have ways of finding out if you're actually scamming me or not. Essentially I've just found out that I don't feel comfortable with how our customers are being treated in the shop. Brand is just growing and growing and growing. There's a lot of every drop is more and more successful. We make more and more clothing as much as we can each time. A lot of this is expensive to do, like manufacturing is expensive, paying employees is expensive. To make all of this happen is like a huge juggling act. I've been like really trying very, very hard to make it work, and so is Sager, and moving Ern and Brandy out here, and everyone's really trying to make this thing just like, trying to make my dreams come true, which obviously love to design. So dropped like 100 shirts last year. But it's a problem, you know, and it's been a real issue, and I haven't known that it's been an issue, and I'm taking responsibility for it because it's my fault. It's my fault for letting other people fuck up. It's my fuck up for letting other people fuck up. If they fuck up on my behalf, then it's my fuck up. So I'm apologizing. I'm very sorry for anyone whose time was wasted. If you felt like you were bothering us because we fucked up. You didn't get your shirt. I mean, I can't do anything about some of the deliveries. Like, USPS still kind of sucks sometimes. There's nothing I can do about it. I just want everyone to know that your support and your love and all of this is everything. I started a YouTube channel just to start a YouTube channel. And then people took note of all kinds of things that I was doing, which is the coolest thing that's ever happened to me. Coolest thing that's ever happened to me is people taking notice in a world where it's kind of hard to get noticed. So I really appreciate that. I value that. And I don't ever want anyone to think that I don't understand buying a $30 t-shirt or an $80 hoodie, or some of you have bought $200 hoodies, that's a small deal. Like, I don't think that's a small deal at all. I know that you go to work and you can spend your money wherever you want, and you spend your money supporting me. As of last week, I'm pretty sure that I fixed everything. We fixed everything, and from this point on, there should not be any issues. Ern is not here today because he is going through every single email and trying to get back to everyone. We're trying to get in touch with anyone that has an ongoing issue. There may be some issues that we don't see. If you don't receive an email from us in the next, 24, 48 hours, certainly feel free to email us again and let us get to the bottom of it. If you've been turned off by us or something happened with customer service and that's what's gotten you to just be like, yo, I love you, Teddy, but fuck this shit, like, I'm sorry. I don't expect you to come back off that alone, but I just want you to know that it's not the intention. It's not how I set things up, and it's certainly not what I expect when I buy something. I just wanted to clear that up because it was a really big deal last week. I know sometimes, like, on here I seem like super aggravated. I know, like, Ern understands it because Ern's known me for a long time. But just know that there's always shit going on behind the scenes, and like, I want to be transparent about everything going on. I'm not trying to hide shit from you guys, but to a degree I still have to keep everything like chill. Sometimes I know I'm moody. Yeah, so like I said, I appreciate you guys' support. Everything should get fixed, like already be fixed. Yeah, from this point on, I think that there will be a completely new tone to our customer service. If you don't get that type of response, please feel free to reach out to me personally on whatever avenue you need to reach out on. So, because yeah, this shit right here, this whole world, like all of this, everything I do is everything to me. So, and I, no plans on slowing down. So now I need to move computer things and clean and get ready to go to the mountains and clear my fucking head for a couple of days after a crazy ass week. United Arrows pants that I got. They're really, really strange. I don't really know. They're like, if there was a snowboard pant made of this that was warm, it'd be tight, but they're a little weird. Yeah, they're 3M, dog. So, yeah. $200 retail, though. Not really worth it. Just to be honest. It's all taken apart now. I don't really know if I'll be able to get it all back together, but it's all taken apart. Looks like we'll have to go buy more shoe shelves again. Yeah, don't bring it back. Bring it back like a motherfucking Jordan 3!
Nice.
Do cable management, they say.
It'll be easy.
It's really not that easy. New respect for cable management. Sure, I'm not doing this correctly at all or in the most efficient way, but I'm gonna try and figure it out by the end of the day.
I don't know. Cables.
I guess it's just like an organizing, get rid of the fucking tangled cables kind of motherfucking goddamn week, huh? Sometimes life goes that way.
Oh my God. This is taking way longer than I would think it should take.
So fucking frustrating. I don't even know what time it is.
It's way later than it probably should be.
It's 3:13 right now and I'm still doing this.
4:30. We're still not completely done, but we're as close as we've gotten yet.
This is crazy. Like, I'm perplexed as to how people, I mean, I know there's an easier way to do this. That was like the most intense game of Tetris puzzle I've ever tried to play.
5:12. 5:12, this is done. I'd say the cord management is pretty good. I mean,
I made this rack, sort of, for everything to run under. And in there, it's a little crazy, but it's all hidden, and it all makes sense, and they're all connected as best as they could be.
Speakers need to go up there, and I don't have any shelves, so I gotta get some shelves for that.
Yeah, just hook up a bunch of other random stuff, and then that's it, we're done. But I gotta get ready for this phone call at It's like 6. It's like a FaceTime call. I'm going to be on Monday Midsole at the Monday Midsole on Instagram. Gonna be on there in just a few minutes. And yeah, I'll be back with you here soon, camera. I need to pack and head to the mountains. So I have Airbnb for the next couple of days. He's gonna meet me up there. He's supposed to meet up there. Him and Brandy are trying to sort out all the emails and customer service issues we may have had that fell through the cracks. If you did not receive an email basically by the time this is up and something happened, please reach out and Ernie will take care of you and we'll try to get this figured out. So he'll get that done and he's gonna meet me up in the mountains. Much needed a couple of days of head clearing coming up. Head to the mountains, so. And Omar's not here. Omar hasn't been here all day. Omar went to go play with the horses. He went to a horse farm to go play with dogs and run around with horses. But while I'm gone, this Airbnb doesn't allow dogs, but also a friend of mine, their dog passed away. Their dog actually had to be put down like 2 weeks ago. And Omar has been going over there to do a little like therapy work, basically, you know, just help them not be so bummed out. So that's where he'll be. And that way I can just go shred all day.
You're gonna need those?
Yes, maybe. I might need the shoes. What hat I brought you was that white, that easy hat.
It's a Y3 hat.
Y3, whatever. I don't know. What's the difference between Y3 and easy?
What?
Easy is Kanye West.
Right.
Y3
is... Is that the same thing?
No. Y3 is Yoshi Yamamoto. He's a Japanese designer.
Oh, I should have known that.
Yeah.
I'm starving.
I'm starving.
We're stuck at the tunnel. It's closed. 45 minutes later. It's green. Yo, is it 6 floors? Oh fucking god. Oh nice, it's 2 floors. How do you turn those lights on?
That's it.
Man. How do you turn that big light on? What? How the fuck do you turn this light on?
These are cute.
Well, that's a little bed.
There we go. Found the lights.
Oh, jeez.
We got snow. Ugh. Oh, yeah, bitch. Oh, yeah, bitch. It's sunny up there.
So nice today with all that snow.
Like the way that sausage stank. Hey.
The move in Breckenridge is Daylight Donuts sausage rolls. They are 90 cents a piece. I'm gonna make Ern eat 100.
It's breakfast. This guy's kind of being a choke.
Okay, so this morning was fun. There was a lot of snow, but I hit a tree. It's not on film. It's not on film, right?
No. Probably not.
No, but I hit a tree pretty hard in my leg, and it feels like...
I thought you broke it.
Yeah, I thought I broke my leg, honestly, but it feels really bad, and I was forced to leave the mountain, basically, and then I guess I'm gonna try to fix it over the next 12 hours so that I can snowboard again tomorrow. But right now it feels like somebody is stabbing me behind my knee. It's not positive, but that is the situation at hand. So we're gonna go and find some biofreeze and some food and do Breckenridge things and wait for Ernie and Brandy and hope that my leg is not broken. That's where we're at. All right, I'm signing off because I feel like shit.
Biofreeze.
and get some ready for
it. You need alcohol.
Biofreeze on. Well, that feels like absolute shit.
Now we're at Breckenridge Brewery. Getting some food. Listening to some fucking blues. Some jazz. Some rock. Yeah.
It's great.
And it's snowing. Still.
Nachos help heal the body. All update on the leg situation. First off, it's freezing motherfucking butt bookie ass cold.
24 degrees.
24 degrees to be precisely exact. But my leg now, from walking from the restaurant to the car, feels as if it was made of glass and the middle has been shattered. It feels like a broken window. It's in my knee area. So, we're gonna go to the hot tub so that I can soak my leg.
Catching the snowball fight in action.
Some Nerf guns, maybe start a little Nerf war for when Earn gets here. Ooh, look at this thing. That's a bootleg Nerf gun though. Look at this kid. Wow, motherfucker. Hyper fire though. Then there's the Retaliator. What are these?
Nerf bandana. What
the fuck, I got tactical weapons, flashlight grip. Ooh, these look like they hurt more.
Nerf mega.
Whoa, they've gotta be rated the same, it won't be fair. What? 4x elite? This is 6x elite.
It's not fair.
You're dead in the water already before we even start shooting. Oh, this is what it is. I didn't notice it because of the packaging. All right, I'm into this Nerf rival.
These ones, yeah.
Ooh, these are expensive.
Don't worry. Do it. Let's go.
What's the
East versus West. Team red, team blue. Nothing. They're the same gun.
Oh, sweet. Yeah.
The VX700. You know, there's a lot of jokes. I'm going to go East versus West instead of the obvious Crip versus Blood. Nerf rival. Here we go. Do we need extra bullets?
If you want them.
They're only $7. I say we get an extra bullet. How many come with it? I just remember as a kid, you never get anything.
Seven
rounds?
Yeah,
it's
bullshit.
Get out of here. Let's go.
We're shortly going to be asked. Hey, we got to go. We're going to be asked to leave. Come on. Tired. I'm just gonna lay here for a little bit. I'm sore and tired.
Let's go get some food. Mm-mm. Or do you want me to go get some food?
Mm-mm.
You want me to go get pizza?
Mm-mm.
Where is it?
Hmm?
Where is the pizza?
Outside.
Whoa.
I think I broke my leg.
No. Not broken.
What about my MCL? My ACL and my PCL?
Okay. So, I think it's time to admit that I've maybe hurt myself. I don't really know for sure, but my leg really hurts. Not just hanging out, but if I try to like pivot, go up or downstairs, or put a lot of weight on it, it's really bad. I don't know. I just like I hit a tree pretty hard, and yeah, I'm pretty bummed, honestly. It's been a really shitty week. So, yeah, that sucks. I'm trying to hopefully wake up and feel better, but I don't know. And speaking of shit, the Nerf gun, where is the Nerf gun? I don't have it. The Nerf guns are so trash. Seriously, an in-depth Nerf, whatever that shit was called, Nerf React. I don't even know. That shit is so trash. It's so trash, man. It's the worst. If I was a kid and I paid $50 for that gun, I would start a fucking riot inside Toys R Us. Straight up. There'd have been a riot. So a lot of things, this vlog is very long. Or maybe not long, but a lot of days passed. Last bit of news before I sign off and try to edit this vlog and go to bed, recover, heal in the night like Wolverine. Info is the Prince from the art show will be dropping tomorrow, actually, at 10 a.m. So that's mountain time. 10 a.m. Snake Prince. signed and numbered, and yeah, limited to 100. They're $70. They're 11 by 19. They're on I don't know how to say it. Geekly print. And then also, as a an attempt of appreciation, we're going to tomorrow load the website up with a bunch of stuff that we have left over, and that's also been found this week that should have already been accounted for. We're going to load all that stuff that we found up onto the website, and it's going to be discounted. T-shirts will be $20 and hoodies are going to be $50. So that's tomorrow. It's for 24 hours. We're going to load it up. Oh, it's teddy.com. I'm going to get out of here. I am super stoned. I'm very tired. And Ern's not going to get here till late, so I can't even attack him with this shitty Nerf gun until late. I have to basically stay up. Nerf, you failed me. Maybe I failed myself by not just going classic Nerf. I don't know. My leg hurts. Alright, I'm out. Peace.
I had this elaborate plan yesterday, Ern.
Hold on. I need to think. Okay, tell me what it is.
Well, I want you to think. I'm going to let you think.
Also, I was telling you earlier, I had this elaborate plan last night to attack you when you arrived. So the plan was to have all the lights off in here, leave you a key, and have you come to the front door. And then I was going to have this laying outside.
I saw
loaded,
those.
Loaded with a note that said, arm yourself.
Nice.
And then I was going to have you come in here to this bunker and get shot. You know, I was like, I'm just going to attack. And then I was going to give you 7 bullets, and I was going to have all these bullets up there so that you had nowhere to go.
It's like real life PUBG.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was trying to create for you. These are $50 a piece.
Jesus, for those, I haven't used the ones with the balls yet.
Yeah, 50 bucks. I'm going in. There's going to be a full Nerf Rival review soon.
Yeah.
These are pieces of shit.
Are
these
they?
These are trash. Yeah, there's a red one upstairs that's been unboxed. It is crap. You have to pull it back and push it forward, and it shoots one bullet.
Like a fucking...
For $50!
Like whatever action rifle, like the fucking pump action...
I'm like, $50, I should be able to like...
Yeah.
Spray the whole community with a fucking... So whack. So now we have sound.
Why is it on?
There's the battery's dead! Check the light! Why don't you ever check the light?
Maybe it was working before.
So you got all the shipping issues fixed this week?
Yep.
Earn customer service guru?
Yep. Whoa. Oh shit.
They don't hurt.
Oh shit!
Look like they hurt.
They don't.
Oh shit! This UK cheese is the fucking best batch yet. I don't know if you can see.
You're always with that.
I love it. I went in to get a gram of wax to give to Sab. I saw an ounce of this and I was like, all right.
Is it real silver?
I don't know. Yeah.
I had to melt down my YouTube plaque, man. Check stop coming.
It's the most money I made off YouTube in a year.
Yeah.
Once they stopped monetizing everything.
Oh shit, son. YouTube unboxing. Exclusive carrying case. Damn it. Oh shit. Very few YouTube creators accomplish this. I've astonished. Bro, I have an astonishing. I thought it said I astonished 100,000 people. It's not there. It's underneath.
There it is.
Here we are.
Hold it up.
Prestigious award.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Put it on the wall.
We don't live here.
But for now, just for the day, for the weekend. We'll make it our home. Yeah, look, by the wipe your paws.
We end up leaving it there.
I know.
I'm going to get it turned into a medallion.
Oh my God, please do.
I'm going to diamond crust the play button.
Oh yeah.
You would.
I'm a YouTuber now, I'm sorry. Push play. Push play, fam. Change my name legally to Push Play. Hey, just Push Play.
How do you guys get the cardboard box a break?
It's because we use the cardboard box.
Yeah.
Nice. Fuck all the haters from Mark. All you haters out there watching, fuck you. That wasn't for me, that was from Mark. I can't remember.
Oh, because your phone's always...
Yeah, it was either Lars... This is Lars Nelson. Stop dropping your fucking phone, love you, Lars Nelson. So this goes to your call.
That is awesome.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah.
Another present I got is a busted knee.
Yep.
Bubble wrap, I'm telling you.
Oh, man, I want to go ride so bad.
Then we can go.
There you go.
Oh, nice. Did you roll that?
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
It's alright, but we'll see. That's gonna fuck it up, right?
It's a little air pocket, a little lung.
That window's open.
500 milligrams. I was pretty lit last night.
So lit.
On like maybe 200 milligrams.
That foot. Right foot.
Does it go over the hood of your jacket? Is that normally how you wear your
helmet? Oh, I even know I have that out.
I'm kind of worried about you going out by yourself, to be honest. Oh.
Back.
Yep, y'all have fun.
Aww.
I'll be here with my leg.
Yeah, oh, almost forgot my gloves.
Don't forget your gloves.
Yeah.
Peace.
I've been
you got the keys,
you.
Alex? I forgot my phone already. Got half an hour. All right.